Chapter 1. Why would it decided to write this book, The True Life Story of a Passionate Immigrant Parent? Our Canadian-born daughter was a little over 5 years old when it dawned on my wife and I that she may never understand nor speak our native heritage language. We had to discover how to instruct her in such a way that she would be able to carry on a simple conversation in our native language, and something had to be done soon. Our daughter, Oyenuga, or Ore for short, had been attending a 2-hour weekly session at the Heritage Language School that teaches children from our culture how to speak and understand Yoruba. Originally from Nigeria, our heritage language, Yoruba, was being lost as the years went on and more people immigrated to this country. The school is a blessing that has helped her better introduce Ore to our language, culture, and given her the opportunity to interact with other children from within our culture. The school offers all children the opportunity to learn what our home country and culture is all about. The problem at the time with the current curriculum was that beyond the 2-hour Yoruba lesson, she had very little follow-up for the rest of the week. Everywhere she looks, she is bombarded with only the English language. Be it at school, church, the playground, sporting events, etc., she sees nothing but English. At home, we tried to institute Yoruba language-only speaking policy, but we did not follow through and were not well prepared on how to truly teach Ore Yoruba as a second language. You learn your language and customs at a very young age, and some find it difficult to instruct others. We simply lacked the training and discipline of teaching Yoruba as a second language and knew we must find the right technique and consistency that would ensure success. Frustrated with the current situation and observing lots of older immigrant children that had lost touch with their parents' language and culture, we did not want Ore to grow up that way. With a passion, we disliked the certain future for Ore that could possibly spell identity confusion for her. We also thought the awkwardness of family gatherings back in Nigeria, where Ore would appear an outcast not understanding our language. We were determined not to create a future situation whereby Ore would be like a stranger to her grandparents that did not speak English. What a shame that she would not be able to communicate with her relatives. Something had to change, so we embarked on a journey to find a solution to this problem. In our search for a creative solution, we began interviewing immigrant parents that we found were successful in teaching their children to speak their ancestral language. As well, we also interviewed immigrant parents that were experiencing the same problem as we were. We interviewed heritage language professors. We spoke and gathered ideas from the heritage language teachers. We also used other sources as well in the course of our search. Ultimately, my wife and I organized a mini-seminar, our private focus group, that featured immigrant parents from almost all continents of the world to discuss issues on the importance of passing on their ancestral language to their English-only speaking children. The focus group was an amazing eye-opener for all of us. We discovered that the issue of passing on heritage languages to children of immigrants, such as ourselves, was an important issue in the mind of all those involved. Our focus group also reached out further into their communities, and we found that lots of immigrants were in the same situation as we were when it came to instructing their children in the mother tongue of the family. They lacked the time and know-how of how to pass on their cherished heritage language and culture to their children, especially when their child's first spoken language was English, or the language of their current country of residency. With lots of generous ideas, techniques, and the simple motivation to teach our child, we began implementing simple tools for Ore. We have gathered hundreds of tips and leads on how to instruct a child and broke those down into the most important, hence the 101 tips. Within weeks, Ore was able to carry on simple conversation with us in Yoruba, and she was motivated daily with fun items to challenge her young mind. She began to become more interested in wanting to know more of Yoruba language and the culture. It was a great success to us, although there was still some mix of English in her Yoruba language. That was a big stride. Getting started was the most important aspect. We achieved to get her to speak our language in such a short period of time, We decided to hone in on the special ideas that really motivated her to make that amount of time even less. We now see this as a way to pay back to the community we love and to help other immigrants to teach their children how to speak in their mother tongue. We have created some novel ideas, tips, and tricks to provide children a fun and easy way to learn. This was the motivating factor for writing this book, the thought of millions of children losing the ability to speak their native language or forget special customs was heartbreaking. Please don't get me wrong. I love this country and all that it has done for me, but I also believe we should cherish our history and share it with others. If we are unable to pass this on to our children, it would be a terrible shame. How would they pass this on to their children or share it with their community? Have you ever been to a restaurant that claims it was authentic, only to discover the food was bland and lacked the flavor of culture? How simple would it have been to teach the child who prepared the meal the proper ingredients to make it as their ancestors had? One thing I want to make clear to all parents is that they are not alone, and teaching their child can be a fun and an enlightening time for all. How much closer will you feel to your children when everyone speaks the same language and understands the culture and history? We have found that this has brought our family together and made that family tie even stronger. We have strived to make this book easy to use while creating a pleasant learning experience for your child. With our sincerest regards, we wish you much success to you and your family.